To Aelita, the new line, and success. I believe we now have a company structure that is dynamic and that looks to the future. I have the utmost confidence in you all, and you can have confidence in my belief in the manager's right to manage. You're in complete control of your areas.
Good.
Remember the Aelita philosophy? Take a little magic to the woman on the streets without it costing the earth.
If you put potato sacks on a rails up there, it's still blind.
I want to take this opportunity to extend my congratulations to Pete Barry, area manager from the so-called declining north and a survivor from the old regime, who this year has managed to turn over stock at a rate that is equal to nearly half the combined southern sales figures. I think that's remarkable.
Well, I'd just like to return the toast to Selwyn, our new managing director, and to the new look lady, Aelita. And may we all prosper off her.
Radio Liverpool, listen, John Badley, not badly, badly, but really, really. Good morning, Liverpool, wakey, wakey, rise and shine. Come on, get down to work, it's wonderful out, let me assure you. All right, lads, out of those beds, put on the socks, we're waiting for you. Now then, what have we got this week? By the way, Alan Kendall, I was in conversation with him yesterday, the Everton manager, has announced that the third leg in the Christmas Age Sports Spectacular will be at Goodison, as promised, next Sunday, kick off 3 o'clock. So next Sunday, boys, have your lunch, have your beers, and get right on down to Everton.
You should have done that last night instead of watching the football.
Exactly.
And then I'm finished now.
Are you going to be able to manage the laundrette?
Yeah.
Well, you'll have the baby in a pushchair then.
Oh, I'll manage.
Oh, I don't think we should mend that bloody machine.
Why not?
Because it's always going wrong. It's cheaper to get a new one.
Oh, so.
Perhaps after Christmas, eh?
A start. Ta-ra. Mind how you go.
Hello.
Cubs. Hello, love. Sorry. Excuse me, if I'm late, we're all late. Do you mind? God, in my day, you did that in the back row of the pictures. Wearing that to sell in?
Ooh, if you pay me, kid.
Oh, glasses.
Watch out. Sexy socks.
Oh, morning, Mr. Barry.
Right, Babs. There's going to be a lot of changes around here. This new guy in London, he's got some great ideas. I mean, the stock is fabulous. We're going to go for the younger woman. Oh, you want to see the designs? I mean, they're beautiful. Music, mirrors, very upmarket, very tasteful.
Yeah. Do you want some stuff moving along?
Oh, yes, thanks. Would you excuse me a minute, Mr. Barry? Can you come up to the stock room with me, lads? How are you keeping? Can I give you a lift?
Okay. Yeah, thanks.
Come on then, Princess. In you go.
We're down Huntley Road now.
Oh, right. You've been busy since Tate's.
So has Stevie's nipper, aren't you?
Do you ever see any of the others?
No. No, I've not had a chance since we moved. She set her heart on it. Thought it'd be a fresh start and all. It's not like the estate where everyone's sticking their noses in. They all think they've got to have a wash and a shave before they come to our house now, you know.
It can get a bit lonely in the day, though, even with our little Rosa.
Look at the state of this place.
I came and watched them pulling the tower down. Just watched it falling. That was a bit of an anticlimax, really. It didn't just go down, it broke in stages.
Just a heap of rubble.
They've started on the flats now, you know.
We've been thinking, actually, of doing a follow-up feature on the workers. A human piece, you know, what everybody's doing now, that sort of thing. Maybe you'd like to give us a hand?
Yeah. Yeah, give me a ring at home in the day. I'll give you the new number.
State of you, you scrappy fucker.
Hey, it takes one to know one.
Don't be cheeky.
Hey, Pete, you're going grey, you know.
Oh, yeah, I'm still good looking. Look at all that. You're going to have to smarten up. I'm going to change this shirt.
You're going to look great in one of those new dresses we've got for you. Sit down now. Look at this silly zip.
Yeah. Oh! Oh! Keep it honest to yourself.
Oh, come on, you like a bit of cop.
Oh, Pete, get off, will you?
Mm-hmm. Lovely. Yeah. Down there.
You know your trouble, Josie. You've been out up against too many backyard walls. You've got love here, though.
Hey, where's Babs? Where is she?
I'm gonna stop you.
Hey,
doing up? Have you left Jude on that till?
That bastard's been messing about with me again.
So what else is new?
I want it stopped, Babs.
Josie, you know what he's like. It's your own fault. Why don't you just stay away from it?
That's not the first time. He's always like it. Are you blind? Haven't you got eyes in your head?
Hey, hey, now you just
calm
down. How
would
you
like it if
you
was on top of
you
all the time?
Now you just calm down. I'm sorry, I didn't realize you were that upset. I'll have a word with him. I'll definitely have a word with him. And then if... I'll make a complaint. Are you all right? Want a cup of tea? Then would you be good enough to get back down to the shop so I can get on with the stock? You cheeky cow.
He's right.
Very, very obvious. So that will give them the first down. Talking to Mike Ditka yesterday, I asked about the sign.
Clear up and clear out, all of you. Look at the state of this place. If you want to live like this, you can just get out.
Thought you said it was all right at your house.
Oh, come on, Mike. Give us a lift downtown.
Sorry, mate. You haven't got a helmet. And remember, what's behind your ears, will you?
Bye, Mr. Flynn. Sorry about the mess.
You lucky lot opt in. 4 days, yeah? What are you going to do?
Nothing, love. Get out of here and I might enjoy myself.
Remember, Josie, you can't be good, be careful, you can't be careful. Oh, Babs, finish that last window for me, will you? See you about 10 tomorrow.
Mr. Barry, can I have a word with you about Josie?
Oh, yeah? What's this about Josie, then?
Well, basically, it's your attitude. I mean, I am the manageress here, and I do feel responsible for the girls, and she was very upset over what happened today.
Babs, I don't know what you're on about. Explain yourself.
What you did wasn't very nice. I don't want that going on here, and the girls don't like it.
You're imagining things. You're doing very nicely, Mrs. Flynn. Let's get on with it.
This was your first assignment, wasn't it?
Yes, that's right.
We've just heard that you've been invited over to Brussels. Do you feel that this indicates a change of mind by the EEC food authorities?
No. This is not an ordinary trade union dispute. No, I am a member of a team representing the workforce in a fight to save our jobs. We are all under the threat of the same EEC policies. So on this issue, our union and management are in a fight to save the refineries and, in turn, save jobs.
This is Joan Sankey, Mersey reporter. He was a fitter for 20 years. Became a shop steward after 8 years, and by the end, he was virtually a full-time official, working with the management on the rescue scheme. Bought out the house with the redundancy money, and his wife's gone back to work, so now he's... Well, he's a housewife. Right, now watch this bit. This is 8 years later, after 10 years of negotiating.
Oh, you seem to have got to know each other very well.
Well, basically, we shall never forget what we've seen here today. We, all the officials, even the management, we've just been down to the House of Commons to hear the announcement. The government spokesman just came out and announced the closure of the works. We've done all we can to give the government a strong argument, or to put to the EEC as to why the work should remain, but at the end of the day, they're not interested.
Thank you, Kieran. Okay, inboard it.
Where the bloody hell have you been? I thought we were going out tonight.
Yes, we are, love, we are.
What are you playing at, Kieran? I come home, there's no one with the kids, there's nothing for tea, the house looks like a tip. I'm not working all the hours got sense for you to go down the pub with your mates.
I'm not your bloody poodle, you know. Do this, do that. I'm your husband, you just remember that. Think you're so high and mighty, don't you, with your fancy job? Jumped up shop girl, you think you're God almighty. Hello, Paula. Hello, princess. Look, Tim, look. I got us fish and chips, didn't I? Didn't I?
Teddy, we'll see you there. If your dad's coming, make sure he's got a clean shirt on. Come on, Tim.
Kieran, it's Dad. It's Rock, Kieran.
Sir.
Well, don't all talk at once, will you?
Fart in a spacesuit, didn't it? Wake up, will ya? All right, we've got some good acts for you tonight. We've got some great ones. But to start it off, we've got a fella back due to popular demand. You know him well, he's been in here before. A local lad, very funny. Put your hands together now for Tom Pepper.
Hey, what's doing, man? Happy apologies. Sorry I was late. I was coming in tonight. There was a girl on the step. She was in tears. I said, what are you crying for, cock? She said, yeah.
I thought, let him wait.
Nice to be with you at Crocky British Legion once again. As soon as I walked in, I felt at home. We haven't decorated in our house in about 15 years either. And this stage here, look, my dad died on the stage like that. If it hadn't been with the rope around his neck, he'd have broke his ankles.
Did he ever try anything with you, Babs?
Oh, don't be so daft.
Before Babs started, he was asking and asking me out to dinner with him. Honest to God, you can't refuse the boss 50 times and get away with it, can you? He took me out for a drink. Then it was dinner at some Greek place where all his mates were. And he introduced me as his wife. Nothing believed him. I felt really stupid. And that's when I wanted to go home. But he kept on plying me with drink and it was hands onto the table.
Well, of course, at your age, you should have known better.
That's got nothing to do with it, Babs. He's got no right to abuse her. Anyway, Gail, I got home and sat and started puking all over the bathroom floor.
Said you bloody well right. I hope Eddie made you clean it up.
But it's not funny, really. I mean, that's sexual harassment.
Oh, yes, please.
Sorry, Eddie, I could do with a bit of sexual harassment, eh, Eddie?
Behave yourself, you silly man. It's going to be worn out by the time I'm 35, the way she's gone.
Will you give that child a crisp and stop tormenting
him? Don't tease it, Tim.
He said to me, if you marry him, I'll give you 15 acres of land and a cow. I'm still waiting for the land. I met it in Blackpool, like, you know, Blackpool, Christ. We'd done all our courting up there, you know, Blackpool. Under the pier, we'd get under the pier in the evenings, it was going dark, and you see all the couples lined up, no under them posts, and it was all that. My one said to me, isn't it romantic? Listen to the crickets. I said, there, zips your pilly.
Sod, you missed a really good night.
Yeah, I know.
But what?
Well, everything. Everything just got on top of me.
Well, now you know what I felt like for 23 years.
Yeah. Cheeky bugger. Hey. No, don't, Babs. No, don't. No. I'll tickle you back. You don't have to go in, love. Why don't we take this back to bed, eh?
Oh, I do have to go in.
And it's not for all day.
You're not even getting paid overtime for it.
You're going to make yourself ill. You ought to give them bloody fags up.
Yeah, yeah. Don't care and don't scrape so loud. Oh, stop it. Morning, lads. Hope you haven't been waiting long. Bloody awful day.
Oh, bloody weather. Morning, all. Morning.
Morning, Mr. Barry.
Nice monkeys. Right, how about a cup of coffee?
Yeah, that'd be great, thanks.
It's up in the stock room, love.
No, I'll make you bags. Make a coffee.
Well, I'm not bothered for a coffee for myself, but I'll show the lads where it's kept. They'll need it next week.
Didn't you hear me? I said go make the coffee.
It's all right, Mrs. Flynn. I'll do it.
It's no trouble.
All right, miss. Any jobs going like?
Sorry, pal. We're okay. I don't like your attitude one bit, Mrs. Flynn.
What do you mean?
I don't know. You seem to want to invent problems for yourself. It's your personal trait, really. You get yourself involved with things peripheral to the job.
Such as?
Well, take yesterday, for instance, the thing with Josie. You've got it all wrong.
Mr. Barry, that wasn't peripheral. If one of my girls complains repeatedly about something, it's my job to sort it out.
Look, Babs, let me explain something. My relationship with Josie is not just a working relationship. We go back a long way.
Well, you may think you're having a relationship with Josie, but Josie doesn't think she's having a relationship with you.
Mrs. Flynn, I think it's high time you and I parted company.
What's that supposed to mean?
I'm sacking you. Is that clear enough?
You're joking over this. That's ridiculous.
I'm not satisfied with your work. I want you out. Now.
I see.
You're back early.
I got the sack.
I suppose I'll have to start looking for another job again.
You've been looking for 3 years. There's nothing. You know there's nothing.
You're too old before you're 50. I told you it was too much taking on this house.
Here we go. It's all back to me again.
Well, this is the last thing we needed. How the hell are we going to cope? Is the mortgage, the rates, and all the bills?
You don't have to tell me what's going out of this house. I know what's going out of this house.
Yes, and I know what's not coming in now.
Look, Dad.
No, you've got it all wrong again.
What is wrong with you? You always fly off at the deep end before you hear me out. We're just putting our view across, that's all. Mum can make her own mind up, but she doesn't have anything in writing. The union can call the bosses up, and then they'll know she's represented, and we can organise any action or pickets officially through them.
Look. You may think you can do what you like with that lot out there, but you're not leading us up the garden path.
For God's
sake.
Keep
your militant rubbish out of this house.
Okay, look, I agree with you. Yes, it's important. Of course it's important to talk to the bosses, but if the union ring them up, then they'll have to take it seriously, won't they?
There you go again, you see. You don't use enough of this.
What are you talking
about? You always have to go headlong into a confrontation. You never think for a minute that there might be another way.
What other way?
First, she should ring the managing directors, tell them the situation.
Yeah.
Once they know what's happening, then they may look at things differently. But tomorrow, whatever happens, she must go into work as normal.
We're all off until Friday while they redo the shop.
Whatever. But she must go in then, otherwise it's a tacit acceptance of her dismissal. She's got 3 days to talk to the managing director.
And talking did you a lot of good, didn't it?
I mean, properly speaking, they can't sack you unless they give you something in writing.
Well, they did.
You talk to Brian Lewis. He's the official down at the union.
I've told her that, Grandad.
You have told me this, and as if I've told you, no one in the shop is in the union, and if they were, they wouldn't come out anyway.
This is me dad talking, and he doesn't know his arse from his elbow.
Hey, hey, now you just mind your mouth.
Well, look at Tate's. They bent over backwards to accommodate management on conditions and everything, and they still got the sack.
Oh, ma'am. He wasn't to know how it'd work out.
Yeah. They never put up a proper fight. Him and 2,000 others got sold down the river.
We ever heard all this before?
Go on, lover. What have you got to lose?
No. I've made up my mind. I don't think the directors know what's going on down that shop. I'm going to talk to them first.
You do what you like, girl. It's up to you. But remember, a boss is a boss is
a boss.
Look, Mrs. Flynn, if you feel that you really do need to see Mr. Dunlop about this, he'll be visiting the Bowl Street branch next Friday to see the refurbishments. I'll ask him to have a word with you then. Is that all right, Mrs. Flynn? And a good day to you, Mrs. Flynn.
Well, I can tell you that it left a very nasty taste in our mouths that day.
No, cut it, Alan. I'm sorry, Kieran, we'll have to do that again.
Yeah, I'm sorry, John, I'll go and see what that is.
A cake and a bun, clad hands, daddy come.
Hello, love.
It's a daisy. Hello, love.
They won't be long now.
What do you mean they won't be long now? You said they'd only be an hour.
Oh, yeah. Listen, could you make us some teas? There's five of us.
Oh.
And could you try and keep the kids quiet?
Any time. Did you hear that? Got to be very, very quiet. What's your favourite? Ginger creams or jamboree?
Jamboree, please, Mum.
Right, they'll get ginger creams.
Got to get up and fight. Keep yourself busy. Not that I've had much time to think since my redundancy. My wife's now working full time, so I've started a new career as a housewife. Well, the world changes, you know, and if you want to survive, you've got to change with it. I mean, you haven't got a lot of choice.
And cut it. Thanks, Kieran, that was terrific. Okay, boys, that's a wrap. Let's clear up as quickly as we can.
Come in, love.
Do you want this tea now? Will you have a cup of tea?
Oh, Babs. Oh, thank you so much. But I'm afraid we've got to rush. I am sorry.
Oh, what a shame. So I'm still working full time, am I? Mm. Well, I hope to God the key still fits. It does.
Oh, my God, come and look at this.
Oh, I'm going to go and sign up.
It's great, isn't it?
Certainly elegant.
Look at the
now, don't
it.
Touch anything, June,
like
please.
Oh,
you've no style.
No one will buy
trouble.
This round here.
It's going to be your job to sell it, isn't it? Well, it looks second-hand, but it's expensive.
Yeah.
Hey, these are cupboards. Wow. Woohoo! Well, you'll need new frocks for here, girls.
Hey, what do you think? Have you seen that? Yeah, it's over there. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
said, oh, what?
Where do you want it?
Give us a swap.
What the bloody hell's going on?
But, Mr. Barry, you are being totally unreasonable.
Look, isn't plain English good enough for you? I've told you you are sacked, and I want you out of this shop now.
And I have told you I want to have it in writing and with a reason.
All right. I shall call the police.
You can take it from me. It's 854-5267.
Yes, police.
Could you send someone around here straight away, please? The address is Aelita Bold Street.
I shouldn't have said anything.
Oh, don't be so daft, Josie. What he did wasn't right. He was way out of order. Of course he had to speak. Oh, well. I better go down and wait for the police to arrive.
Look, I'm not losing my job for whatever she's done.
I've been told you've been causing a disturbance.
I am still the manageress of this store until I have it in writing that I have been sacked.
Well, I've been told you're not.
Correct.
But only by him.
Now listen, is this your manageress? Is this your manager?
He's our area manager.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Flynn, that's how it stands.
Look.
I've been told you've been causing a disturbance, and if you don't move now, I'm going to have to arrest you.
Well, I don't want to be arrested. But I do want you to make a note that I am not causing a disturbance, that I strongly object to what is going on here, and that you have had to forcibly remove me as witness by Mr. Barrett.
Look, woman, the door is that way.
Hey, hey, I'm going for my coat. You see what I mean?
I can see the logic of it, but I'm just doing my job.
I'm not blaming you, but there's more to this than meets the eye. He's been misbehaving with my stuff. That's why I won't give him the in writing. I know this.
Some gain recognition and even fame, but when you talk of MC, IC is the best, and when you talk of DJ, forget the rest.
She nearly finished. I'll just...
What did he say?
Didn't see him.
Why ever not?
Because Barry had me kicked out of the shop by the police.
You what?
I was kicked out. I wasn't allowed to see the fella.
So what do you want to do?
Is it too late to see that man from the union?
Come on, Mum. I'll get my coat.
Okay, Josie, you just sign this. Fine.
Look, love, I've got to go.
Oh, thanks, Josie.
Good luck with it all.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Right. Let's see what they've got to say for themselves.
Mrs. Flynn's been sacked from our company, then it must be for a very good reason. Yeah. No, that's all I'm prepared to say on the subject. Quite frankly, no, I don't want to talk to your union. Okay, bye.
Well, if they won't talk to us now, what are we going to do?
Oh, not to worry. They're always like that at first. Mark! You spare a minute.
Hello, Kit.
You got problems? Something your lads might be interested in. All right.
You see, the management are refusing to hold talks, even to discuss Babs's dismissal.
She hasn't even had it in writing.
I mean, today she was threatened with arrest by the police when she turned up for work. Oh,
which is very unpleasant. I didn't think it would be, but it is.
However, tomorrow the shop is having a champagne opening launch with Miss Lovely Legs.
So they've very kindly arranged all our publicity.
But it won't be the kind of picket that we used to. It won't be on shifts, you know. 9 to 5.
What does that mean?
Well, all day, every day, a real commitment.
Listen, I hope you won't... I don't want to be rude or anything.
Go on, Mum.
I don't want any punks outside that shop. Well, it may be very funny to all of you, but you know what I mean, Arsene.
You don't mean...
Well, if you know what I mean, no, tell them what I mean.
Stevie, Babs has got a very good point.
Am I right?
No, it's a very good point. We'll be outside a shop, not a factory gate, so we'll know we're dealing with the public.
Joe, she's such a snarler. I told you, don't worry about it. Babs will sort it out.
I'm not even supposed to speak to Babs. He's threatened me with a sack.
So you shouldn't go around signing statements. You should let me sort him out, and that would have been the end of it.
Oh, great. Then the two of us would be out of a job.
Sorry I spoke. Joe, you know, it's not my fault I haven't got a job.
Idea, I never said it was. But we can't both live on the bloody dole, can we?
I manage.
Aye, is it? Oh, look, I'm not blaming you. But the only way you manage on your dole money is because I pay for the beer. I also pay for the bog roll. Your dole's just pocket money.
Josephine. It goes with the boots.
I'd feel much happier if you were there.
Well, I'm not going down there with that lot. I know that Mark Gettings, he's one of our Stevie's lot.
But why? Just for the beginning.
Got my own reasons, and that's that. Anyway, you've got your official, and now Stevie.
Yeah, but the person I really want is you.
The whole thing won't last longer than a day, anyway. It's just one of our Stevie's games. Anyway, you moan, and you're just standing there waiting for a bus.
Oh, come on.
No, I'll stay here and get on with the house.
Keep it smiling. Okay, girls, Tracy, Justin, up here. Come on, what I'll pay you for. Right, Tracy, over there. Justin there. Nice smiling. Come on, sexy socks. Plant. There you are, you look beautiful. Okay, here we go. Nice and calm. It's going to be a great, great day. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Okay, faster.
All right. I ain't gone. Ladies, you want to spend your hard-earned money? Come on inside. Take the notice of this lot.
The
champagne is free.
If you don't stop blocking the entrance, we'll have to move on.
Well, now, it's only the public that's stopping to talk to us blocking the entrance. We keep moving round.
So long as you keep it three each side of the door, okay?
All right, sir.
What's the trouble?
Right. Back in business again, eh?
Happens in the police force too, you know. Locking the door, sir. It's like this might be a long one.
Nice seeing you. Thanks,
though. Managers don't get the sack for nothing, you know. She must have had her hand in the till. Anyway, good luck to you, Mrs. Flynn.
Well, thanks. Look, let us sign this petition, will you?
Thank you.
No doubt I'll see you at the checkout. Just get your name down there.
Come on, girls. Cheer up. Have another drink. There you go. Thanks. Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, it's great.
I see you smiling. Come on, sit down.
Trade union rights for women workers.
Well,
you will.
Of course you will. Bloody hell, look who it is. Oh, God, I would get air, wouldn't I?
This is an interesting turn, Babs. Kieran never said you were union-minded.
Perhaps he didn't think you'd be interested, Jo.
Could I set something up with you over here?
Yeah, that's fine.
Thanks a lot.
What's the problem?
Well, it's just, I don't mind doing this. I could just wish it wasn't her, that's all.
We need the publicity.
I know, I understand that. I mean, don't, it's just, oh, never mind.
Trade union rights
for women workers. Support the picket against
unfair dismissals and sexual harassment at work. Support
the
workers'
right to jobs. Say no to sexual harassment. Ah!
Because I feel responsible for the girls. Everybody wants to know about it. Everybody
no, don't cut it. Please, don't stop. Josie, it'll be all right.
It's all right,
though. Oh, look, God, Steve, she was so upset.
It's obvious, isn't it? He's been getting
out. Oh, where were we? What question were we on?
I'm sorry, I can't...
Oh, never mind, I'll pick it up. All right, carry on. Now, Mrs. Flynn, what precisely are you claiming as sexual harassment?
Sexual harassment is... Well, it's a new name for an old problem.
And
it's a problem that many
there's
all
my man, Shelley!
Recognize. It's something that can happen to men just as easily to women.
Quick, you're
talking
gonna miss it!
To people who've been outside this shop today. The reaction is, really, I was very surprised from pretty well all of them. They don't want that kind of thing.
What do you think of the chances, Dad?
It could be their daughter working in there.
Not a hope in hell.
Or their wife or their mother. And
what are we going to do for Christmas, then, eh?
One very disappointed mum, that's what.
Yeah. And no turkey. To congratulate ourselves. We stopped
all their trade. The only person who's spent any money in there today has been Miss Lovelylegs. It's cost the company a lot of money. We've got 4,000 signatures on our petition, and the management has said yes to talks in London.
How long will you be maintaining the picket?
The union's agreed to call off the picket until those talks take place.
What should have been an enterprising new concept in boutique marketing has been disrupted by industrial action.
Well, what can we do for you, Mr. Lewis?
You call this meeting, Mr. Dunlop. What can you do for us?
Well, as much as possible, obviously, but we need to know what the problem is.
We consider that our member has been unfairly dismissed and mistreated by your company.
On the first point...
No, hang on a minute, let me finish. No disciplinary measures were proposed. Mrs. Flynn was removed from the store under threat of arrest, and she still hasn't received written notice of her dismissal. The other aspect is the sexual harassment, which we believe the incident stems from originally.
Mrs. Flynn, were you personally harassed?
No, I was complaining on behalf of...
We do have evidence of the harassment.
Evidence?
I don't think we need to discuss that. I think that's a matter for Mr. Barry and his solicitors, from whom you'll no doubt be hearing. I think I should make it clear, Mr. Lewis, that as far as we're concerned, Mrs. Flynn is not
an Aelita person.
Mrs. Flynn, you have to understand that Aelita's is a concept that has to cover our entire attitude. And it was Mr. Barry who decided you weren't an Aelita person.
But Mr. Barry took her on in the first place. We're not a Tuppenny Halfpenny union, you know. It's only fair I should warn you what you're getting into.
I understand you, Mr. Lewis. Would you excuse me for a moment, ladies?
Could I get you some more tea?
No, thanks very much.
Has Mrs. Flynn been in your union very long? She fully paid up. Perhaps a month in lieu of notice would help her out.
As you know, I'm just the official. I can make recommendations, but I can't come to a decision until I consult my member. So, I recommend that you carry on fighting it, but it's up to you and Barrett to decide for yourselves, of course.
Not an Aelita person. What a load of rubbish.
How much are they offering you, Babs?
Oh, he didn't put a figure on it, but I shouldn't think much.
Put the picket back. We made a mistake there. We should never have taken it off.
Yeah, we've come this far. We may as well carry it through, girl.
I agree.
Well, if that's all right with all of you.
The evidence is strong with Josie's statement.
Well, I propose we put the picket back until we win.
Well, I'll second that. Yes.
All in favour?
Yes.
Well, you're just brilliant.
Right, let's have a drink.
Clear off and try working.
Excuse me, my man. How much would it be for your sexual harassment today?
About 80 quid a week with lunch and pasties, right?
There you have it, my dears. A bargain and half the price.
And how about you, young man? Some Tory titillation, perhaps?
Morning, Father.
How are you doing?
All right, no sign of petition. That's our Stephen.
Hey,
Grandad. Green union rights for women shop workers!
Support the pickets! Union rights for shop workers!
Get out of my way, you dummy bastard!
Hey, you!
How's it feel to push around an old man, eh, mate?
Are you all right, Dad? Just get your breath. Just get your breath. You're all right, Dad. It's all right. Just
you're all right, Grandad.
You better take him home and we'll stay here. No, you won't. It's a lousy day. I'm going to take him home. Just get your breath back.
Grandad, come on.
We'll stay here.
Come on.
No, Tim.
But, Dad, we always get sweets.
£2.10,
please, Mr. Flynn.
Thanks, love.
Reinstatement!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Reinstatement!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
I believe it constituted a public disturbance outside
Elita, A-E-L-I-T-A, Bold Street.
Right. Thank you, Constable. Okay, love. Just give us your name, address, age, date of birth, and phone number.
Do I have to tell you?
Look, love. You don't have to tell me. I'm only here till 11 o'clock tonight. We can keep you here 48 hours.
574.
Were you born around here?
What do you mean by that then, Sergeant? I'm not answering that. What's the reason for asking me that?
No reason. Just procedure. Take it away and search you.
Drugs?
Yeah.
That's blatant discrimination and harassment. Take your hands off me. Let go of me, will you? Let go!
Take your clothes off when I tell you, and in the order that I tell you.
Over my dead body.
Take your coat off.
No.
Right.
No! No!
Right, get her legs.
Ow!
Hold her down.
Stevie! This strip's hurting me!
That's it. Stay still.
Going to charge us?
I don't know.
If they do, doesn't that entitle us to a phone call?
Supposedly, yeah.
The stripping her, Mark.
I know, well, you're not going to help, are you?
Well, we're not having
sitting
out here,
are we? Listen, you're making worse for Paula. Now, stop it.
All right. What's the problem, then?
I want to make a phone call. I want to know what you're doing to my girlfriend, and I demand to make a phone call.
Well, would you know? You'd like to make a phone call. Why make a phone call?
Well, I believe my rights entitle me to make a phone call when I'm being charged.
Right. You're entitled to one, but you're not going to get it now.
What are you talking? Get off!
Stay calm, Stevie!
I am entitled to a phone call. When can I make one?
When I feel like it.
When will that be?
Yeah, lovely. Okay. Josie. Jude.
Okay, Jude? Yeah.
Girls. I just want to say how proud I am of you all. The way you stuck by me this last week. And as a token of my appreciation, I've booked a table for four at the Adelphi tonight.
Yes, the Adelphi?
Yeah.
Thank you, Peter.
That was
doing, Kieran? Have I gone mad? The pickets have all been nicked. What am I doing?
What are you talking about? You've got all them lads supporting you. They're not going to give up because they've got nothing to lose.
So don't you go on about giving up for them.
We're going to go in there and get them out, right?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, right.
I really don't want to go. What does he think I am, eh? A slave or something? He thinks he can click his fingers and I'll just come running.
Well, don't go then.
You've got to go.
You haven't got to do anything. I mean, the guy molests you in work one day and you're going out the Adelphi with him the next. Come on. You're asking for it.
I was just doing my job. I didn't ask for anything.
I didn't say you did.
You did?
I didn't mean it like that.
Trish will be there. I'll be all right.
You better have been. Do you want me to pick you up?
Yeah.
All of you, you know.
When are you letting them go? What are you charging them with?
I'm telling you, you're not going to get away with this, you know.
Our MP and a solicitor are on their way.
Look, sir, I keep telling you, sit down and shut up, look, or I shall have to ask you to leave.
Oh, leave it. It's like talking to a bloody brick wall.
Can I have my belongings, please? Mark Gettings.
Hiya, Babs.
Are you all right?
I can't believe these bastards.
Have you seen our Stephen?
Yeah, he's all right.
We know each other, do you?
Yeah. Listen, I'm getting on the phone to my MP and get a solicitor down here to find out where they put the others.
No, I've done that. They're on the way now. Oh, a bit late, aren't you, lad?
There's our Stephen. Stephen, are you all right?
Mum, thank God you come. The strip search, Paula. I want to see my girlfriend, Paula Douglas.
Stevie.
Oh, Paula. You all right?
Yeah.
Come on, love.
You all right? You sure?
Yeah, come on.
Today, eight pickets from the unemployed branch of the Transport and General Workers Union were acquitted of the charge of obstruction after the magistrate heard contradictory evidence from the police. Additionally, the court ruled to set up an inquiry into the case of one picket, a Miss Paula Douglas, who was strip-searched whilst in police custody. Miss Douglas, Miss Douglas, could I have a word? Could you tell me, how do you feel about your experience?
Well, it was a very humiliating experience. I wouldn't like it to happen to anyone else. The charge of obstruction didn't warrant a strip search. That's just another form of sexual harassment. I think the whole abuse of police power is terrible, and it's up to us in the trade union movement to expose it.
I've spoken to the pickets, and they're prepared to step up the action. Now's the time when the management think they're on top. I've been thinking of putting a picket on the other branch as well. Good. In fact, we could mobilise nationally, set up pickets on the shops just about everywhere, bring their trade to a standstill.
Bloody hell, Mark. Nationally, I can't ask people to do that, not for me.
Some people know what it's like to lose their jobs. They don't want to see other people going down the same road.
Yeah, but nationally...
Listen, love, they'll fight for you all the way. And so will I.
Oh, look at the state of me. What do I look like?
What do you mean you look crazy? Well, I think the procedure now is another cup of coffee.
Okay, love.
Recommend is that we take out an injunction to stop secondary picketing.
What does that cost?
Initial injunction, about $2,500. That's ex parte, of course. For the full injunction, it could come to $10,000, maybe $12,500.
How long?
A week. But if they then ignore the injunction, we'd have to go for contempt of court. And that's another 2 or 3 days at least.
With additional trading losses every day.
Their media coverage is getting totally out of hand. It's killing us. Sexual harassment in the fashion design business. It's easy meat for the mags. I've even heard that Vogue have done a piece for next month.
Fuck, it has to stop. We can't afford it.
Well, I consider it to be a bad decision on your part.
Look, the point is, Mr. Dunlop, if I could jog your memory, you did assure us of a completely free hand in the running of our particular areas.
Sure, Pete, a free hand to manage, not a free hand to run all over the girls. It would seem that Mrs. Flynn was only upholding quite correctly Joseph's complaint. Let's not forget the statement she signed. I see an awful lot of shit you've got into. Would you consider Mrs. Flynn's reinstatement as an option?
Mr. Dunlop, I've already taken on Tricia Lane. She seems to fit in with the new concept.
Oh, sure, Peter, she's fine. She's terrific. But, I mean, fuck, is it worth the hassle?
girls. Perhaps you'd like to have a little read of our leaflet. That'll explain to you what's going on. And then if you think that what we're saying...
Who's talking to you, Nuzio? Talking to this lady here? You look like a load of old rubbish anyway.
As I was saying before we were so rudely interrupted, if you just have a little read of what is there...
Mr. Lewis, I hear you're picketing our other Liverpool branch. Now look, I'll be straight with you. We're willing to talk again, but you've got to call off the pickets first.
I see. It's all right. Talks are in hand.
I told them we'll call the picket lines off in the meantime, like before.
No chance.
No, come on. You've got to call the lads off. You'll scupper the negotiations. She's going to get a job back.
A job, maybe. It might even be okay, but we'll have to see what Babs thinks first, eh? And you might as well tell them the only way of getting this picket line off and getting their business back is to meet all of Babs' demands.
Oh, sellout. You've been on this picket line for weeks. On your bike.
On your bike.
Pull him back.
See his face? It was a colour of bullshit.
As far as we're concerned, we're saying in the Liverpool Labour movement that Liverpool has suffered enough, and the Labour movement in this city and in this country must be committed to the socialist transformation of society. Thank you very much.
Comrades, I'd like to introduce you to our last speaker, Mrs. Babs Flynn. Now, she's not used to speaking at meetings, but she needs all our support to assist her in the speedy victory of her dispute. I'll hand you over then to Mrs. Babs Flynn.
Firstly, I'd like to thank you very much for inviting me to speak here today. We've been picketing my store in the centre of town for 3 weeks now, and no one has crossed that picket line. Anyway, I'd just like to thank everyone involved for their support. I know there are a lot of very important battles going on at the moment, and so our fight might not seem so important. But I represent what is happening to a lot of women, what's already happened to a lot of women, and what I have no doubt will happen to a lot of women. I got the sack. I got sacked because just for once, I stood up for myself and the girls in my shop. What do you do when a boss sexually harasses you or your staff? Now, that was a new word for me. I didn't even know that that's what it was. I just thought that it was the man misbehaving himself. But why should women workers put up with this sort of treatment? And what do? When you get the sack? Do you go on the dole, like all those millions of others? Or do you stand up and fight? I don't think you've got a choice. Not when you've got a family and a husband out of work. You have to fight. And that's not an easy answer, because it's not easy to fight. It's hard when you're abused by the company, the police, and the press. One of our pickets was groundlessly strip-searched by the police. For what? For picketing. Now that's another example of harassment. But we're determined to fight on until we win. And not just for me, but to show other women that you can win, that the union will fight, and that workers do stick together.
We've got
to
keep a united front.
To help us step up our public,
it's just not good enough. If we keep, we want this sorted out this Christmas, not next.
We'll win. So please,
Brian, either you're with us or you're not.
We can't do it. What's the point of calling mass pickets? All they'll do is slam us all the time for sequestrations.
We're picketing 6 days a week, 8 or 9 hours every day.
You've been in the trade union movement long enough to know that we can't win with all the odds stacked against us. It's an illusion you're creating here. It can't achieve anything.
I mean, it's not like picking a factory where you're just on the go for 1 hour when people go in and out of work. Picketing a shop is a day-long job.
Listen,
the unemployed branch,
if you're a trade union leader, your wages are paid by us, the members. You're there to lead us, not sell us out.
Well, they are.
You're out of order, Brian. We've got no option but to fight. Nothing to lose and everything to gain.
So please do picket duty. It would be really appreciated. And can I just say, I've never been to a meeting like this before, or any other meeting for that matter, and I've certainly never spoken at a meeting like this. I've never been active in the union or in the labour movement, but I can tell you something, I am now.
Kieran? Not bad, eh?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, she seems to have struck a popular chord. Oh, by the way, the Tate's material came out beautifully. In fact, you must let me take you out to dinner. There's a lot I need to discuss with you.
What was that?
Who thinks I'm a slag or a traitor? I've had enough. Eddie, I can't take it anymore.
They might be right in a way. It's like you're betraying your roots.
Right, that's it. I wait till the end of the week. And then I'm out.
Mr. Lutman.
Hello. Well, tomorrow's the big day. London. Meeting with Dunlop.
Me dad not back yet?
No. Must be a good interview, eh?
Anyway, you've got to get your beauty sleep so you can hammer the bosses.
You should be in bed.
You all right, Mum?
Yeah.
Hello. I've got a train to catch.
Oh, you're meeting, yeah. Good luck, love.
I've said I'm prepared to backdate your pay to the day of your dismissal.
I think we should discuss this, Babs.
I want complete reinstatement.
We've offered you reinstatement.
As assistant manageress at the North Street store.
Just be on the same salary.
I want the same job in the same store. And if I don't get the same job in the same store, pickets supporting my demands will be outside every one of your 23 stores nationwide.
I think the High Court would take a dim view of that.
I wonder what your union leader thinks of that.
Be under no illusion, Mr. Dunlop. The members of the union are pledged to support this particular dispute right to the bitter end.
We've made you a very fair offer.
It may seem fair to you, it doesn't seem fair to me. I'd still be marked as getting the sack, albeit unfairly. I want the same job in the same store.
Support the picket. Boycott Alita, official picket against sexual harassment. Transport General Workers Union, official picket against sexual harassment and unfair dismissal. Support the picket. Union rights for shop workers.
Excuse me. Who's in charge of the picket?
Well, I'm the steward, if that's what you mean.
You're Mark Gettys?
Yeah.
There's a call for you inside.
We are one, we are one, we are one. We are one.
Babs. I want to say that. I want to say how much I love you. I'm very, very, very proud of you. And it's not. I want us to be together.
I love you too.
I'm so proud of you.
As we turn another blind eye again, oh, they steal it from you. But the feeling's coming back. Guess it always will. And no matter what you feel, love will always find a way.
You know,
honey, just for you. It might take